now. It's one of the most versatile fabrics in the world, and whether you like it or not, you are probably wearing some of it at the moment.
We're talking, of course, about polyethylene terephthalate, also known as polyester. This year, it's celebrating its 70th anniversary.
Well done. I gave Andy that today, because I wouldn't have made it. We would have run out of time. Anyway, to mark the occasion, a cabaret performer from Sussex is launching a new show to share her love of all things polyester. Rachel Hepworth has been rifling through her wardrobe.
One, two, three, four. P for polyester.
Oh.
It's made of oil.
L.
I love it dearly.
Why?
Because you don't have to iron it.
From house coats to shell suits, artificial fibres have always provoked a mixed reaction, but not for Lorraine Bowen from Brighton.
It's colourful, it's durable, it's crease-free, it's gorgeous. I just love it.
S.
Just a little bit sweaty.
T.
Touch and you'll get the
E.
An electric shock.
She's been collecting polyester fashions since she was 16 and views them as a piece of social history.
What on earth would you describe that as?
This is a house coat and not a dressing gown.
What's the difference?
Oh, you can answer the door in this.
Have you?
The Amazon delivery man has never been the same again since I went.
So passionate is she about polyester that Lorraine has written a cabaret show to mark its 70th anniversary, featuring the history, the science, and her favourite fashions.
Yeah, I call these pieces of art. They're just beautiful. Look at this Hawaiian outfit.
30 million tonnes of this stuff is created every year, making it the most widely used material in the world. Impossible to imagine when it was invented by British scientists Winfield and Dixon.
They created this kind of murky brown resin that didn't look like much in the bottom of a beaker, but as soon as they started picking it out, it became a polymer, which is like strands of material, very much like nylon to start off with. And that's the raw, basic polyester, which you can then create all these wonderful fabrics out of.
Over subsequent decades, it became the fabric of choice for fashionistas.
This terephthalate viscos pinstripe sells at well under £40.
It does shriek 1970s, doesn't it?
It does, it sure shrieks, yeah. It's not so nice to wear, but it's really great to look at. And I must admit, sometimes I look around the high street at the moment, I just think, oh, everyone looks so droll in their baggy cotton. It all goes out of shape so easily.
That being said, there may have been a few fashions we'd rather forget.
Got static hair as well now.
I feel like the love child of Demis Roussos and Nana Mouskouri in this. It's just lovely.
Or maybe just a bit of shoplifting. You could get a fridge out in this.
And worse was to come in the 1980s.
Who would wear something like this and where?
I haven't got a clue, actually. I just found them in this shop and I think who on earth would even invent something as ridiculous as this with horse riders on? Look at these baggy sleeves.
Maybe Jimmy Savile. But they have given birth to the shell suit and leisure wear. I mean, that's where polyester seems to be going these days.
Yeah, I don't like those. I won't even put those in my show because they're too baggy.
And who can forget those brushed polyester sheets?
You just move a little bit in bed and it's whoosh off the side of the bed there.
They are quite flammable, actually, aren't they? They could be a bit dangerous in the wrong hands.
Really dangerous. Of course, in the age where people smoked more, then you'd have a lot more house fires.
As shown by this health and safety film from the 1990s. But for all the downsides, polyester has shaped the way we live with its styling, durability and versatility. From high-vis gear and boot technology, from plastic bottles to space suits, both the real ones and those which are a little more improvised. Definitely worth making a song and dance about. Rachel Hepworth in Brighton for Meridian Tonight.
Life's good when you can enjoy polyester in such a way.
I feel a bit underdressed after that, to be fair. Fred's back next week. We'll make sure he's wearing one of those garments.
He never wears polyester. Yeah. It's all the finest silks and cottons.
The same for Martin Davis, to be fair. Actually, polyester, it's not really the weather for it at the moment, is it, Martin?
It's a bit on the hot side, isn't it? There's lots of lovely places you can go to keep cool this weekend, but there are plenty of ways you can get hot under your polyester collar as well, I suspect. One of the nicest places to go, out in the countryside, of course, where the camera's out and about today, up in Oxfordshire. This is one way to keep cool, of course. Go for a little paddle in the River Thames, maybe. Beautiful up there, isn't it? Lots of sunshine around today. A bit isolated showers in the north of our region today, believe it or not, but for most of the time it's just been gloriously dry and sunny. And